Ano po yung, what made you agree to joining the cast and to being Tori?
Well, to be honest, when I heard that there was going to be a pitching for High Street, and this was, of course, being offered by my Dreamscape family, I honestly didn't care so much about what project it was. I didn't care so much who I'm going to be with. I didn't care so much what the character was going to be. Mm-hmm. I wasn't very particular this time because this is the first offer ever that we are welcoming after the passing of our mentor and father, Sir Deo. Mm-hmm. So while I'm very careful now of the projects that I take on, only because I have three kids, no? And I'm very hands-on. And I realized that over time, if I wanted to be there for them, I have to cut down on things that I do. And I'm an entrepreneur, I do speaking engagements, I coach, and I host an everyday show on the Kapatid Network. Mm-hmm. If I added on taping for teleserye, I knew I wasn't going to see them as much. Mm-hmm. So it was very intentional, but at the same time, I didn't need to know what the character was for High Street because I knew, dahil lumaki naman ako sa Dreamscape, that whatever they offer me was going to be something I'm going to be challenged doing. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Only because Dreamscape has offered me over time shoes that were always bigger than my feet. Meaning, it was always something that was going to push me to be better. I always come out better after a Dreamscape teleserye. Kadena Ginto, Mara Clara, Agua Bendita, Ikaw ay Pag-ibig, Huwag Kang Mangamba. All these things, all these shows have helped me become the actor that I am. And more so, a woman as well. So, yeah.
Mm-mm. You said iconic ang role po ni Tori. Can you give us... What can you give us about, what can you tell us about your character?
Well, right now, what I can say is that Tori is a venture capitalist. So, in business, that is somebody who takes on a role of holding equity in a brand or in a company, owning the company, building. And right now, she's into big business. Mm-hmm. And this is how her character is introduced in the beginning, no? She's very complex, and that's why I love her a lot. I think early on, you can tell that she's iconic only because everything she does is always intentional. Mm-hmm. Parang wala siyang ginagawa na walang intention. And that, for me, is an icon on its own because I've played some characters also that were always... unsure, and that's okay also, but ako, I gear towards having characters like Tori, who's very intentional in everything that they do. You just know, and yun yung aabangan mo na parang, ba't niya yung ginawa? May dahilan yun. Bakit mo to? Kasi diba may mga eksena na you just do the scene because it is supportive of other people's characters, while with Tori, she's very character-driven. So her character alone somehow navigates through the show in that sense.
Did you have to adjust pa with Tori? Or is it like, sa dami ng roles na na-play mo na,
oh, no.
Meron ka bang adjustment sa ganun?
You know, siguro, it's a common misconception when you grew up in a business like I did na you sort of parang debuton na lang, like everything comes in easy because nasanay ka na. But in reality, at least for me, it is always something new. Di naman din kasi ako lumaki na parang gusto kong maging artista. It was never a natural choice for me. It was always, well, I became artista because somebody saw me in the mall, brought to Mr. M. So it was there, the opportunity was there, I grabbed it. Mm-hmm. And even throughout the career of mine, it was always like that na parang, oh, there's the door, it's open. While I work very hard, ako lang din kasi, I work through whatever I do. Like, for example, if you give me this, I'll work on it. Mm-hmm. So I never want to waste any opportunity that's given to me only because feeling ko, hindi yan darating sa'yo kung hindi para sa'yo. Mm-hmm. And in the same way, hindi siya darating sa'yo kung hindi para sa'yo. So I'm always very mindful of that. So, yun, parang ako lang... there was always a big adjustment, especially for Tori, because I took an acting hiatus from October until now. And for me, that's quite long. Kasi sanay ako na I jump from one teleserye to another. And often, I shoot for the next teleserye even before my current teleserye has finished. So, it's quite long for me. October, November, December, January, February, March, April, May. So, 8 long months of just hosting and coaching and speaking engagement. So, nanganay ako. Parang ako mismo. But kasi naman, excited din ako to do characters. So, that kind of helps.
Pero yung ganyang perspective, at least parang hindi ka nasasana, hindi ka nagiging comfy. It gives a new perspective whenever you try on a new role.
Yeah, definitely. And also, I think it is a great application even when you are a non-celebrity. It gives you a sense of pride in everything that you do because, you know, pinaghihirapan mo yon. When anything kasi comes to you easily and you think you can easily do it, not only do I feel arrogant when I feel that, but I feel like there's no more room for improvement. For me, kasi feeling ko, alam ko na. So I'd like to always put myself in a position, even in this, in our industry, where I don't exactly know what to do. That kind of excites me.
Meron po kayo nabanggit sa BTS na women who never give up? Ano po ito? And may relation ba to kay Tori?
No, women who never give up, I think, is our Viber thread. Ako, si Ate Angel Aquino is there. Ni Ethel Espiritu, who's our who's a producer in Dreamscape also. Now she works outside of Dreamscape, but still heavily with us. Miles Ocampo and Ate Nikki Valdez. This is yung women who never give up actually came from the idea that we never give up kasi sending our free dates, hindi kami magkatagpo. So we call each other women who never give up. And rightfully so, kasi lahat naman din kami palaban. So in that sense, para okay din na yung tawag namin.
And sino sa mga character mo noon, yung mga mahahambing mo kay Tori?
Wala. Kasi
super unique siya talaga.
It's unique in the sense na it's gonna unfold over time din naman. It's unique in the sense na iba yung atake, iba yung ways niya on presenting herself. Very, very difficult for me kasi kadalasan, di ba, we think that being out there, whether you are kontrabida or bida, being out there is the best way to go. But the hardest part kasi of being an actor, especially when you've been doing this for a very long time, is controlling yourself. Is making the right choices for particular scenes. So yeah, sure, you want to show all your chops, but when you're matagal artista, what you want is finesse. Diba? You want to be able to just show a little bit for them to get excited over it. And that always is a challenge because it is innate for us human to want to show off all the time. And kahit, diba, kahit ikaw, kunwari, kahit introvert ka, when your time comes, you want to show the gifts that were given to you, diba? Because we all have God-given gifts. But as an actor or as a creator, the work I feel is best achieved when you know when to stop. When you know when to give it, when you know when to give it to somebody else. It is not, well, it is okay for me, well, it is okay to shine all the time. Often you also have to learn how to let other people shine. And that, I feel, makes a very good creator, is when you know when to make these tiny choices.
And that's where the teamwork shows.
Oh, definitely. And in a teleserye, it's never one person. Kahit umarte ako ng mahusay, kahit magaling silang lahat, kung ang ilaw namin hindi maganda, kung ang director namin hindi kami jive, it's going to be very difficult to show the material at its best form.
May special preparation ka bang ginawa for Tori since she is iconic?
Oh yeah, I had to learn how to silence my mind.
Bakit yun?
Well, kasi I'm very excited. I'm coming in cold from a hiatus. That means there's so many ideas I want to give to Tori. So the preparation for Tori is not more like what do I want to do? It's really more what I don't want to do. Yeah. Am I making sense to you?
Kaya lalo ko na-intriga sa kung
very interesting, no? So imagine, for her, it's never about what she shows, but what she doesn't show. And diba ang hirap gawin nun?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Kasi ikaw, sa atin, pag artista ka, when you are in front of the camera, it's always about what they see.
Mm-hmm.
But what they don't see is what excites them.